tackle letters because
that's the biggest lesson of the entire book.
These two things, and you'd literally written, if I could tell my young
that's what I'll be telling them.
It is not your job to fix anyone.
Yeah.
Tell me what you mean by that.
Well, I think, again, not all women, and you've got to be careful when you generalise, but I think we are socialised to take care of other people's needs before our own. And certainly my history of both romantic relationships and friendships, you know, which were very intense, as they often are in your 20s especially, involved me basically being the mother hen who would like, anyone damaged here? Does anyone need some help? Is anyone really struggling? Because I really need to take that on. And you know, just the drama of it and the chaos and the pain and the hurt that that brought into my life. Of course, now I see that and kind of go, yeah, pretty much to avoid your own stuff. But really taking that on, you see that a lot in relationships, you know, and you go, you know, that whole bad boy thing that you're after, like, you can't fix that dude. You just can't. If he wants to change, he will change, and it will probably have nothing to do with you. So, I mean, whether it's your parents, your sibling, your friends, your lover, whoever it is, to kind of go, my shit's my shit, theirs is theirs. If they ask me for help, you know, I can be there. But, you know, boundaries, as the psychologists say.
Yeah, and I think that when you maybe after that, if, whether it be the bad boy or the people taking advantage of you, or even by accident, because they've got something going on and they sort of draw out from you, I'm the same.
Mm.
I think you wrote something like, when I think you met your partner, he was normal, like he was lovely normal and just kind.
Why are you being so nice to me?
And you're like, and solid people are not normal.
Yeah.
They're actually incredibly rare.
They are, actually. And that's the one thing you learn over time, I think. It's the same with friendships, to kind of go, you know, the idea of, oh, yes, this is one of my best friends. For me, certainly in my 20s, that was something I said very liberally. And now I'm much more selective with that, because you realise, no, and a lot of relationships give you different things. God knows, as a comedian, there's a lot of relationships with people who are very self-centered, bless them. They might be really fun to hang out with, really nice to have a beer with. Are they a friend in the sense that when the shit hits the fan in your life, you'd call them and say, bring me a casserole? Not many. So trying to sort that out and kind of put your relationships in their proper place doesn't mean you have to get rid of those acquaintances or fun people, but to recognise, well, don't put all your energy into it either, because the people who actually deserve your energy are you and the people that you love, you know, not just the people who are kind of on the periphery.